Hello guys, it's Deep Shah over here and today I'm going to show you how to create this neon portrait illustration using pen tool and Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So the first step over here is we need to create a line art for this portrait. So there are two ways to go about this, either using brush tool, which is a destructible option, meaning each and every line you create for the art will not be editable after on if you feel that the lines are not proper and you won't have any other option than to delete it. And then the other way is using pen tool, which is a non-destructible option where you can edit each and every line of the art later on if you feel it is not proper. So I prefer creating it using pen tool, but yes, if you have problems using pen tool and are choosing brush tool option, then all you need to do is click on this brush tool icon and then select brush as hard round. After that, set the foreground color as white and then set the appropriate size for the brush. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. And then using brush tool, create the art as follows. So now, as I told earlier that I am creating this art using pen tool, so the first step over here is to select the pen tool and then set the mode of the pen tool to shape instead of path. After that, set the fill as no color. Then set the color of the stroke as white. Then set the appropriate size for the stroke. After that, click on the drop down icon of the stroke type. Then set the align as center. Then set the caps as rounded. And then using pen tool, make the selection as follows. I'm zooming into the image to make a proper selection. Now remember to make the line art using parts so that when you give the neon effect at the end, it will feel like it has been created using neon tubes. After that, once the line has been created, hit the enter key of your keyboard to place that line. Now after that, again start creating a path for the other parts and you will see that it will create a new shape vector for that part as well. So like this, we create a line for the main parts of the face and you can keep changing the size of the stroke to make the line art look more realistic. So now as you can see, the line art for the portrait has been created. Now the next step we need to do is merge the layers for which we need to give different neon colors into a single group. So over here I need to give different neon color to the spectacles over here. So for that I am merging all the colors which contains those spectacles. Press Ctrl while selecting the layers to select multiple layers. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge the selected layers into a single group. So now as you can see, a group has been created with that of the layers. Now if I hide this group, the spectacle should be gone. So now bring this group layer at the top of the layers. So now after that, we need to merge the rest of the shape layers into a single group. So for that, make the top shape layer active by clicking on it. After that, go at the bottom and then press shift and select the bottom shape layer, which will give you the selection of the two layers as well as give you the selection of all the layers in between. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge all the layers into a single group. So as you can see, now we have two groups over here, one which contains the spectacles and one which contains the rest of the line. Now after that, we need to create a nice background for this line art over here. So for that, make the background layer active by clicking on it. After that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select solid color option. After that, select any color of your choice which you would like to give to the background. I'm setting it as 0f0d22 and then click on OK. So now as you can see, half of the part is ready. Now we need to give a neon effect over here. So for that, make the second group layer active by clicking on it, which is the face layer. After that, click on add layer style icon and then select blending options over there. After that, click on outer glow. Now set the blend mode of the outer glow to lighter color. Then set the opacity as 50%. Now set the color of the glow as the neon color you would like to set over here. I'm setting it as 00DEFF and then click on OK. After that, set the technique as softer, spread as 15%, and then size to 65 pixels. Note you can change the settings according to your choice and the resolution of your picture. After that, click on drop shadow. And then set the blend mode as multiply, opacity as 75%, angle as 60 degree, then distance to 15 pixels, spread to 17%, and size to 100 pixels. After that, click on OK. So now as you can see, we have the neon effect for the face ready over here. Now we need to do the same thing for the spectacles, but with that of different color. So for that, right click on the group and then select option copy layer style. After that, make the group one layer active by clicking on it. And then right click on the group and then select option paste layer style. Now we need to change the color of the outer glow over here. So for that, double click on the outer glow option over here. After that, click on the color option and then set the color you would like to change. After that, click on OK. Now keep the rest of the settings as same and then click on OK. So now as you can see, we have a different neon color for the spectacles over here. Now to make the effect look more proper, make the color fill layer active by clicking on it. After that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select brush tool and brush as soft round. After that, set the foreground color as the same color which you have set for the outer glow color of the face. And then click on OK. After that, increase the size of the brush such that it fits the whole face. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of a keyboard. So now as you can see, it fits the whole face. After that, click on the document using the brush tool. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to soft light. And then reduce its opacity to 50%. Now to show you the effect of what we just did, I am clicking on the layer eye icon and again unhiding it. So now as you can see, it gives a nice touch up over here. Now we need to do the same thing for the purple neon color with the spectacles over here. So for that, again create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then set the foreground color as the color which you have set for the spectacle outer glow color. And then click on OK. Now reduce the size of the brush such that it fits that of the spectacle. After that, using the brush tool, click on the document and then again click on the document to the next part of the lens. And then change the blend mode of the layer to soft light. After that, reduce its opacity to 50%. So now as you can see, your neon illustration portrait is ready. Now I'm going to do just one more step to make it look more attractive. So for that, again create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select elliptical marquee tool. After that, press shift and create a small circle and then fill that circle with that of black color. And then click on OK. After that, press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection. After that, click on add layer style icon and then select option blending options over there. Then click on bevel and emboss and then just increase the depth to 1000% and keep the rest of the settings the same. After that, click on OK. And then using Move tool, place it at the edge of one of the neon line. After that, press Ctrl plus J to create a duplicate of this layer. And then place the duplicate layer at the other edge. So like this, you can do this for each of the line over here. Note that this step is not compulsory and I'm just doing it to make it look more better and realistic. Now I won't bore you by showing this repetitive step over here and directly showing you the final effect. So as you can see, this effect is giving a nice look over here, and now it looks like as if a neon tube has been placed between the two pins. So that's it guys, this will give you a neon portrait illustration using pen tool in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.